Can we check the audio, please? Yeah, you're able to get it? That's good. So you were just looking at us making all the adjustments to the audio to be able to speak to you. And all this is a part of what we need to ultimately do if we process signals. To be able to do that, we need to build systems which take signals and give out signals. And we have to build certain common principles for doing this. We have envisaged this whole exposition in the form of two courses.
The first course would aim at introducing the student first to signals and systems in the natural domain. Take the audio signal, for example. The audio signal is naturally a function of time. So time is the natural domain. And obviously it makes sense to start from signals and systems in the natural domain, because that is where we encounter them. However, if you look at here, we've sketched a signal in the natural domain, and it's fairly complicated to interpret or understand. In contrast, suppose I were to transform the signal or to take the signal into a representation into an alternate domain called the Fourier domain. We would see that there is much greater elegance in representing the same signal for computational advantage. For interpretational advantage, it is desirable to look at the possibility of representing signals and systems in an alternate domain. So in the first course, we would look at signals and systems in what is called the Fourier domain. In the second course, we would have two modules, module 3 and module 4. The third module would look at bringing the two together, continuous and discrete independent variable systems together. How would we, for example, relate the magnetic tapes of the olden days, which recorded audio, the cassettes as you knew them, and today's digital audio series? That is the question of sampling and reconstruction. And finally, module 4 would be similar to module 2 in that it would again look at a more generalized representation in terms of a transform domain, but deal with two different transforms for continuous and discrete independent variables with relationships between them, the Laplace transform and the Z transform. So there again, for the sake of convenience and computational advantage, one would like to look at signals and systems in a more general alternate domain. Well, as you can see, there are very exciting things waiting for us to learn them in this course, and I very warmly invite you to learn all these things by participating in this course.